Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Automotive here. Today, I'm gonna be helping you diagnose and fix issues with P0113 fault codes. A P0113 fault code is gonna tell you intake air temperature sensor 1 circuit high input. Fortunately, this is a relatively easy problem to fix. It's certainly a lot easier to fix than it is to say. Ultimately, this engine code is relating to the intake air temperature sensor. So in this video, I'm gonna go ahead and talk to you just a little bit about the IAT sensor, how that works with the intake system. And then from there, we'll talk about a couple symptoms that you get alongside a P0113. I'll talk about common causes of it, and then we'll finish it off with a diagnostic step list that you can follow through to figure out what the problem is and fix it. So the intake air temperature sensor, as the name sounds, reads the temperature of the air that is passing through the intake system. And when you get a P0113, that ultimately means that the voltage reading coming from that sensor is way too high, and that would correlate to an extremely low intake air temperature that's ultimately too low to be realistic. So when it's reporting a reading that's that high or that correlates to air being that cold, the engine's computer knows, okay, this can't be real because of how low those temperatures are. There must be an issue with the intake air temperature sensor itself. The vehicle's ECM or engine computer module uses the reading coming from the intake air temperature sensor, as well as readings from a number of other sensors to ultimately control air to fuel ratios. So when you have a bad reading coming from your IAT sensor, that can lead to your air to fuel ratios being thrown off, which can mess with fuel delivery and ignition timing. And that can ultimately lead to rough idling, hesitant acceleration, increased cranking times, and decreased fuel economy. So while this is a relatively simple problem, there are some unintended consequences that can make your engine run a little bit rough or not as well as it should be. Now, one other thing that's worthwhile to mention when it comes to IAT sensors is there is another type of intake sensor that is usually present on the intake system, and that is the mass airflow sensor. The mass airflow sensor is responsible for reading how much air is being passed through the intake system. Pretty much every car reads virtually the same two things: the temperature of the air that's passing through the intake and the amount of air that's passing through the intake. You might see the terms IAT and mass airflow sensor thrown around a lot. On older vehicles, and some vehicles still today, there are separate IAT and MAF sensors, but in a lot of cases in modern vehicles, the IAT and the MAF sensor are actually integrated into the same sensor. So you have one single sensor that's reading both the temperature and reading the airflow passing through the intake. So what's relevant here is that the MAF sensor in most modern vehicles is synonymous with the IAT sensor. So when you get a P0113 code, it's possible to get a number of other codes that come along with it. If you have an IAT sensor that's integrated with an MAF sensor, then it's possible to also get a fault code for your MAF sensor, something like a P0101 through P0104. You might also get a P012X or P012 something number that's relating to some other temperature sensor. And then lastly, you might see a P0171 or a P0172. Both the P0171 or 172 are going to be effects of the P0113. Like I mentioned, this can cause your air to fuel ratios to be thrown off. And so a 171 or a 172 code is going to show you that you either have too lean or too rich air to fuel ratios. So ultimately, there's not too many things other than a bad sensor or issues within the wiring of the sensor that could be causing this fault code. And so you could just have a sensor that's failing. The sensor could be disconnected or it could come loose. There could be a lot of kind of dirt or debris that's built up inside the connector to where you're not getting a good connection between the pins on the inside of it. Part of the wiring could be bad, or you could have frayed wiring. And then lastly, it could be an issue with your MAF sensor in the instance that your MAF sensor is integrated with your IAT sensor. So ultimately, all the problems point to the intake air temperature sensor. So when we talk about diagnostic steps to go ahead and determine what the problem is and how to fix it, my first recommendation is just to clear the code and see if it comes back. Because sometimes you get a weird, funky reading coming from it, and it's just a one-off. The engine throws the code on there, and it gets stored in the computer. And so unless you clear it, you don't know if it's an active code that, you know, you're still having this issue, or whether it's something that happened one time and the engine's computer just isn't gonna let you forget about it. If the code does come back, then you definitely have an issue with the sensor. And so from there, you'll wanna go ahead and locate your IAT sensor. It's usually pretty easy to locate. It's gonna be located on part of the intake tubing. So find your intake system, and whatever sensor's right there attached to your intake piping or intake tubing is probably gonna be your IAT sensor. Go ahead and pull it out, make sure it's not too dirty, clean it, check the connection on it, and then check any of the wiring that connects into the sensor and see where that goes to make sure the sensor itself doesn't look bad or the wiring isn't bad. And ultimately, the majority of the time, the way to fix this is just gonna be replacing the IAT sensor. If you wanna get a little bit more advanced in your diagnostics, you can actually test the sensor and measure it for resistance to see if the sensor is the actual problem. But fortunately, these parts are usually relatively cheap. And like I said, there's not a whole lot of other things that can cause this other than a bad sensor itself. Probably a good move to just go ahead and replace it, unless you've got the tools and the kind of electrical know-how on how to do resistance tests on sensors and wiring and things like that. Anyways, guys, I hope that this video was helpful in solving your issue with your P0113 fault code. If you guys appreciate this video, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for all the future diagnostic content we do.